We're going to do it in English and Spanish. How's that?
That's wonderful.
Is that okay?
That's wonderful.
That way we include everybody. Vamos a hacer en inglés y en español. I want to thank you all for being here. This is obviously very, very important for the president, and that the commission was chosen in part to listen to the parents and the students and the teachers as to what recommendations we need to submit to him regarding the issues of improving the quality of education so that children not only finish high school but go to college and, more importantly, finish college. And we've had a very successful launch of our first ever website that basically answers every and any question that parents and students will have as to what they need to do to go to college. And this is an incredible accomplishment for this commission and for this president. So we're very, very delighted. We are going to be listening to parents and teachers and students as to what those recommendations need to be for the president. And we're delighted that you're here. We also, and you want to speak about that?
No, just to show me ese es el nombre del website. Y es aquí okay. Yo sí puedo. Y básicamente es el primer paso. El primer paso es un paso pequeño, pero al mismo tiempo un paso gigante, ¿no? En lo que es la visión que la comisión tiene. Una visión que es un reto grande, un reto muy importante. It's a huge challenge, it's a challenge that is not, we know, we understand that there are a lot of difficult questions that are going to be raised, and difficult issues. Son muchas cosas, muchas preguntas, a veces difíciles de contestar, y problemas de resolver, pero nuestra visión es que nunca ha existido un programa o una comisión como esta, ¿no? Con la iniciativa y con la importancia y el respaldo, en teoría, el respaldo total de la Casa Blanca, del presidente. O sea que con esa visión, with that vision, I think it's full steam ahead. I mean, this is like a trickle of water that we're starting, and you know, hopefully we're going to fill up the bucket. When? Well, we'll see. It takes time. Pero yo creo que la visión es, este comienzo para mí personalmente es algo que significa mucho, y soy un producto de lo que son las escuelas públicas, o sea que es algo que sabemos, and we all understand that it's going to take a long, long time. But, we're starting here, we're starting now, there's never been a commission like this, with this kind of initiative. And the issues are important.
Y yo creo que lo más importante para todos nosotros es reconocer que, como dijo John, ya empezamos, el proceso empezó. El proceso,
sí podemos.
Que sí, y yo sí puedo, www.yosipuedo.gov. Y yo creo que lo que tenemos que asegurarnos es de que existen recursos, que los padres, el sueño que tienen de enviar a sus hijos a la universidad se puede lograr. Y hay recursos para que se logre. Y todas las preguntas que ellos puedan tener de cómo hacerlo, porque muchas veces, aunque tengan el deseo de que quieran que sus hijos vayan a la escuela, no saben a dónde ir, no saben qué preguntar, no saben dónde aplicar, no saben qué es lo que tienen que hacer. Y con esta página y con esta comisión, con estas recomendaciones, nosotros creemos que vamos a tener éxito en que nuestros muchachos latinos no solamente se gradúen de la high school, sino que vayan al colegio y se gradúen de la universidad. Eso es lo que el presidente quiere. Él cree que cada niño puede aprender, y él quiere que cada muchacho que quiera ir al colegio, a la universidad, pueda hacerlo. Y estamos dispuestos a apoyarlos con toda la información para los padres para que eso se logre. So we can take any questions.
John, I got a question for you. You said, quote, music instruction should be a part of every child's education. And I agree with that, but with the budget crisis that we're dealing with here, as well as elsewhere around the country, do you have any suggestions to provide these cultural programs without shortchanging our children with class size reduction and the other things we're trying to achieve?
Well, I do think the arts should be a part of a well-rounded education. And you're right, the arts, and I'm the I'm the first one to see it and recognize it, and I've been a part of many reach out programs that deal with how to help the arts survive in the public school systems. This initiative, believe it or not, it's in my opinion, the vision that as discussing the issues and different types of issues that deal with education in general with the other commission members, realize the challenges that exist with funding, actually beyond the arts.
You're right.
You know, funding period. So one of our challenges is, along with the federal government, is how to achieve that purpose. Actually, that's probably one of our biggest challenges. And probably the private sector, through public awareness, the right type of public awareness, God willing, is going to be part of the answer. And in my opinion, that in retrospect is going to help my arts, and it's going to help my music and what I feel and believe it should be a part of, an integral part of our well-rounded education. Help me to kind of have a better sense of what to do when I got to college.
So, Treasurer Marin, let me ask you this. Are you saying that this is an unfunded program by the federal government, or is it a funded program?
Yeah.
And I need to follow that up, if you don't mind.
Sure. As a matter of fact, the initiative itself is funded by the Department of Education. This stems from the Department of Education. With the No Child Left Behind Act that the President signed, and it's becoming law, I think that we are seeing, and as a matter of fact, we are having Brian Jones, legal counsel for the Department of Education, he's going to be joining us for the public forum. I think that one of the things that is very, very clear is not always about funding, and it's not always about more funding. What the president and the secretary, and certainly many experts in the field of education will tell you is that is how do we best utilize those resources, and how do we make people accountable for the existing resources. It is clear to many, many people that somewhere, somehow, our system has failed the kids. The president believes that every child can learn, and it is up to us, and he challenges all of us, and certainly the challenge for the commission is not all about funding. It's utilizing the resources that we have in the most effective way and make every single person accountable for the funds they currently have.
Well, let me follow that up with the question that you're going to have an open forum town hall meeting tonight. What type of questions are you expecting from those people that will show up tonight?
We normally expect questions. We hope that they will also provide some comments and more specifically recommendations. This is the fourth forum that we have held across the nation. We expect to have three more. And we want to listen to people because these recommendations will go directly to the president. This is what the community is saying they need to get their children through college. And I can tell you, it's not always money. And it cannot always be just money. It's the better utilization and making people accountable for the money they currently have. Because not only does the federal government, but the state and the district, we have spent a lot of money on education, and it's clear to us that we have not always gotten our money's worth, and we have failed our children. The president does not accept that, and he's no longer going to tolerate that, and that's what he's expecting through HR1, the implementation of HR1.
Where I'm confused, and last question for me, the where I'm confused is the problem of California has a lot of immigrants coming into the country. We have more than we can't really educate the ones that are here. So I'm really at the point where, and you're really saying there's no more money coming. So I'm just trying to figure out how this all will work out with the state of California in particular, and perhaps Texas and other border states.
Yeah, I think that the question it's got to be, how do we best use the resources that we have, and how do we best make everybody accountable for it? We can come up with a whole bunch of excuses. The president doesn't want excuses. The president wants results, and he's hoping, and as a matter of fact, when he was in Texas, he was very, very successful in bridging the gap of minorities, and including immigrants, in their achievement in education. he did not want excuses. He was able to produce in Texas a very good results for everybody in Texas, for all the kids in Texas. So I think that taking his accomplishments in Texas, if he can, and many of the initiatives that he was very successful in Texas with, many are now reflected on HR1. And I think that just as well, if we can implement those across the nation, that we will succeed in having more children learn more of them graduating from high school, more of them going to college, and more of them finishing college.
Sorry, I was late.
¿Puede en español, por favor, el programa cómo funciona, por favor?
El programa de
no niños que se quedan afuera, ¿nos podría decir cómo piensan hacer este programa, qué es lo en qué estamos en el futuro, por favor?
Estamos a través de la implementación de la ley de que ningún niño se quede atrás. Y lo que esto busca es una contabilidad, una responsabilidad, para que todas las personas, todos los distritos, todas las escuelas, todos los estados que reciben fondos puedan ellos responsabilizarse para que los niños aprendan. Desafortunadamente, hemos visto que hemos dejado a muchos niños atrás, que no están aprendiendo, que no se están graduando de la universidad, de la high school. El presidente quiere, él cree firmemente que cada niño puede aprender y, más importante, que cada niño que quiere ir a la universidad puede ir a la universidad, debe ir a la universidad y debe graduarse de la universidad.
Secretario, por ejemplo, lo que mencionaba aquí el señor anteriormente, que son inmigrantes o no son inmigrantes en general.
La ley federal es bien clara. Ellos hablan de todos los niños, todos los niños. Eso es claro. Each child.
Yo quiero hacer una pregunta. Mi esposa fue maestra de Belmont High School por 23 años. Uno de los problemas grandes que se enfrenta a las escuelas, y sobre todo aquí en Los Ángeles, yo no conozco otro lugar, yo conozco Los Ángeles nada más, es que a diario hay un flujo grande de niños que llegan sin ninguna preparación ingresando a las escuelas. Yo, en ocasiones, esto yo creo que perjudica el desarrollo de otros niños y altera un poco la enseñanza. Yo quisiera saber cómo podría el gobierno lidiar con esa situación de los nuevos ingresos que hay a diario, que es sustancial, se crea la sobrepoblación y todo ese problema. ¿Cómo pudieran lidiar con esa situación, como dice aquí, para que ninguno de los niños se queden atrás?
Sí. Yo creo que lo importante es reconocer que esta ley espera que cada niño sea ayudado de una forma individual. El presidente cree, y él lo ha dicho una y otra vez, que cada niño puede aprender y que cada niño debe de aprender, independientemente de los retos que tiene el niño, incluso discapacidades de aprendizaje, que cada niño tiene la capacidad de aprender, y es el reto que nosotros tenemos de cómo enseñar a cada niño. Yo creo que el énfasis tiene que ser individual. Tenemos que ver al individuo, tenemos que ver qué es lo que puede facilitar la enseñanza del niño para que cada niño tenga éxito. Porque eso es lo que estamos buscando. Estamos hablando de los individuos. Y el presidente, es una convicción que él tiene. Él tiene esa convicción y lo ha expresado una y otra vez. You need no child behind. No child should be left behind. No child. Lo ha dicho claramente.